Hello all. So welcome to another tutorial on CS384. So today we will be seeing the basic variable declaration, strings declaration, escape sequences, bitwise operations. So we will go step by step. So we start with the basic variable assignments. Okay, so you have already done this in C. The same rules remain in Python also, right? So for example, in this example, I am declaring counter as the value 100. Okay, miles is 1000.0. So this says ki, okay, now this is a floating type because it has a decimal point associated with it. Okay, then next we have a name. A name is a string. Okay, the string can be anything. Let's say we can have Sachin Tendulkar here. Then we can just print the values. Remember in C we used to have printf. Here we have only print. Okay, so once you hover over print, you can directly write the variable name. Okay, as we saw earlier also, I am showing it again. We can have multiple assignments in Python. Let's say I have three variables here, A, B and C, which I want to assign the value 1. So you can do by two methods, A equal to 1, then you can write B equal to 1 and C equal to 1. Or since all the values are same, you need not do this and directly write A is equal to B is equal to 1. Okay? You also have this kind of multiple assignment with different values, right? So for example, I write A comma B comma C is equal to 1, 2 and such an. In English, when we read the word respectively, so this is kind of a respectively assignment. So A will be assigned 1 because we begin from the left to right. Then B will be assigned the value 2 and C will be assigned value such a. Okay, so let me print the value of A, then B and then C. And I assume you have installed the CodeRunner extension that I showed in the previous video. Since now that is there, I will directly use right click and run code. Okay. So you can see on the terminal, I get 100 because I printed the value of counter, which was 100. So let me take the console a bit upstairs. Now there is one issue with CodeRunner. I executed some previous program here and the output still stays on the screen, right? To clear that output, let us go to the settings. Okay, in the bottom left, there is a setting icon. And then click on setting. Alternatively, you can use control and comma. So once the setting option is open, you just search here clear output and press enter. Right? Clear output is a string and press enter. Now in CodeRunner, you can see this option clear previous output. So just check this option. Settings are automatically saved in VS Code. There is no need to type OK, apply, anything like this. And now let us come back to the program. So you can see here, I have some previous output. Now when I run the code, there will be no output. Let me right click and run the code. And you see the previous output is automatically cleared. So we have print 100, print 1000 for miles, name is Sachin Tendulkar. And then we are assigning A, B and C as 1 to Sachin. And you can see the corresponding three values appear. Let me just print the value of only the variable C to be very short. That C was assigned to Sachin. Now let me run the code. So C was assigned the value Sachin. Okay. So as you can see, you can have multiple different data types in the same assignment. So A gets the value integer, B gets the value float, and C gets the value Sachin. Okay. So simple variable declaration in Python, just like C, all the same rules are here also in Python. Okay, so the rules for variable name will be taken in the next lecture. That's it for this video. Thank you.